I do feel like this is more than 100 chunks.
The Pomelotto?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Nemo added a few more just to be... I think we're actually the same in Overworld, right? Be safe.
No, in the Overworld we literally cut it, I cut it out at 103.
Okay, then I don't know.
So in the Overworld I even checked like the side chunks and skipped those where they are not zeros and that stuff. Don't think he did this here, so we have a lot of like priority 7s and 15s loaded by this permaloader here as well. Okay. Why do I keep making the same mistake and not placing this block here?
So yeah, the plan for the day is move the shulkers we have trapped here in the mob, switch the old one into the new one over there. We need to do this because we want to lower the entity cramming rule to 24 for the zombie pigment farm. Okay, I think we actually need to go to creative first and design a machine to separate them because of packs of 35 in there.
At some point we definitely had on Orcs 1 or Orcs 2 a world where I've built this up.
I know,
I'm not sure when it was changed and which it was.
I actually built a different machine, but I don't know anymore where to find it. I think it won't take long to come up with something.
Unsticker is simple.
Yeah.
Just, you gotta just be smart about how you get the shulkers out.
I'll just notice the...
30 stacked shulkers that do not move anymore won't move anymore.
Okay. Added a Discord notification that I'm streaming. Yeah, let's go to creative. I think I'll remember pretty much how to make it, so it won't take long to get the timings right.
Especially
84 in Century. Like a tick later or so. I had to push them over. Oh, what happened? Timed out, what? Let's try the Ox one server. I got the...
Ox one should still be the piston test world.
Oh yeah, the piston test world. Oh, okay.
Okay, let me actually try if this is enough now.
Did you change the entity cramming rule?
I'm trying to make a Schalke unstacker, a Minecraft unstacker. I've done it a few times, but I never have it saved somewhere. Unless I can maybe find it.
Did you change the entity cramming rule?
We plan on doing that. That's why we have to fix the shulkers first.
Shulker sort, could that be it?
Sounds like it.
No, that's something different. I think we have to just quickly design from scratch. It can't take more than 15 minutes, I hope. Yeah, we made such a system a few times already, but I don't know. My single player worlds is such a mess. Couldn't find it.
How is this still staying loaded? Come on! Okay, now it's going. Finally. Oh, what happened to the other mob switch?
Oh, not quite.
Where's the exit? Tripper? Didn't we have an exit next to the 7 segment display in the Nether Hub?
A what?
How do I get out of the Nether Hub now?
Other side.
Huh?
The other side is to that Guardian farm.
Yeah. Ah.
I have to actually push one higher.
Oh no, XCOM's dropping X. I can't even do anything with checking the mob switches. There's a teleport bot there and do shit. And I don't want that. Player spawn.
Nope. I think this kind of works. Yeah. Guess we can go for that. It's not really pretty. Let's also try to just shulkers, just to be safe. Hey, someone for you. How's it going? XCOM. Everybody uses the pun pretty much.
Okay, so it must have been weird with the locking the permaload. I summoned in the bot, went there again. Then I went back to the overworld, killed the bot, now I'm waiting. It's fine again.
Oh, thanks a lot, Lucifer, for the subscription. Thanks a lot. Crazy Minecraft. Yeah, it's gonna be a bit crazy with the shulkers. So, plan is to stream for 2-3 hours a day and move some shulkers. Not quite sure if we can finish it. From the old mob switch to the new one, so we can finally play with the default entity cramming rule of 24. Currently still 100. Okay, let's try it again, if it also works for shulkers. Why did the rail turn? What? Oh, because I forgot to remove the one at the bottom. Makes sense. Okay. Yeah, it's working. Okay. That's pretty much all I needed to get this set up here. I think the rest can be improvised and in survival. Okay. So we got kind of, yeah, stacks of 35 shulkers and minecarts. And we have to somehow separate them and put them into chambers where only a single one is in there. Okay. And Methods is trying to figure out.
It just unloaded again.
Mob switches for the other dimensions. Oh. Yeah, maybe we need to talk to XCOM at some point. Maybe he knows more. Yeah, also our Nether mob switch at the moment doesn't work. The new one.
This is such a joke, it worked all the time. So we actually do need the permaloader for this shit.
Yeah, no. No, well, we definitely don't need it for the bat and squid switch. I mean, talk to XCOM maybe. I mean, maybe he knows what's wrong.
And how are these blocks behind the nether portal removed again? Like every second day I go and check the nether portal clock if it actually works and I place some two blocks there so the rails don't fly through the portal and then I come back and they're gone. Someone is like actually griefing me here. Holy crap. Don't remove blocks, you don't know what they do.
So I need to split the shulkers, yeah. That's the idea. The advantage is that it causes less lag, and in case we ever need to bring the shulker somewhere else, then it's also simpler, I guess.
Mango, when you logged in, did you log in the nether?
Yeah.
Oh.
Why?
Yeah, you might have despawned my 700 blazes.
Why? I would get teleported to 0-0 first and not to your mob switch.
If it's before the autosave hit.
Oh, you mean that? Yeah, that might have happened.
I'm gonna go and check. Summon Steven in.
And out of sticky pistons as always. Gotta craft a bunch today. Okay.
Oh, the blazes are still there, so how does this unlock? Village is here.
Hey, MMX. Why does Rand not work? I have no idea. Maybe somebody used it before? It might be a cooldown, I don't know.
These hoppers do all have items, yep.
Building blocks. And last thing, these potions. Oh yeah, we should actually also move over the shulkers we have in the nether. We have 140 shulkers in the nether. In flying machines. They would also get killed. Yep.
Are you still in the nether?
No, I'm brewing potions now.
Okay, then please... Can you stay out of the nether for 2 minutes, or should I wait until you're at the shulkers?
Okay. Can I stay out of it?
Okay. So, I'm gonna go in the overworld, kill Steve. And then we have to wait for the next autosave, or maybe two autosaves. We have to hope it doesn't end.
Yeah, if anything, it's this minecart interaction that causes the lag of the shulkers. Night vision, oh! Damn it.
Okay. Kill Steven.
Brew more potions anyway. Dead.
Yeah, so now they're still loaded.
So shulkers can't collide. They basically don't count towards the entity cramming rule, but the minecarts do. We have the shulkers stored in. From the old map switch in the new one. So we can finally set the entity cramming rule to 24, which is kind of useful for the pigment farms where we kill mobs with entity cramming, so we don't need to use 100 minecarts anymore.
It's still funny that this game rule is only useful for technical players in abusing factors for mob farms. I mean, it actually is completely useless in the regards of what it's supposed to do.
Like the boats and all the light launchers, yeah, they also cost a ton of lag. Why night vision when you have to be... Oh, I want to get invisibility, I just forgot to add the fermented spider eye.
You need another potion brewer where you can throw in messed up potions. Fast one. I wish I could hit save all.
I mean, I got some suggestions to already have the awkward potion brewed, basically. So it would be even faster. But since you need the awkward potion for basically everything except the weakness potions, right?
What? Sorry.
I mean, for brewing systems, it's actually a good idea to have the awkward potions pre-brewed, because I need it for everything.
I think, you don't need the other two potions are pretty much completely useless, right?
Yeah, if you want to make weakness potions in order to heal zombie villagers or whatever, then you need, I think, just the redstone and that's it.
Yeah, but you can still make a weakness potion with an awkward potion.
Are you sure? Right. Oh, go the other way with the melons. Okay.
Yeah. That is actually zero need. I mean, if you want to cheap out on this one glycerine melon, then yeah, you could make like a thick or mundane potion, but I think this is all you can do with them.
Oh, we could actually fly to spawn, yeah. Or can I go to the nether again?
Hey, unloaded! What is this?
Efforts?
Yeah, you can go into the nether, they unload it anyway.
Okay.
Oh, I really don't know, no. Only two chunks stay loaded, this thing. Why? And I checked, they're all like above priority 450, so there's definitely no priority issues with anything. No. Really don't get it.
Got the slime blocks. Might have some ender chest. Yep. Who is keine Ahnung? We just joined the Discord today. I think he was watching streams before, regularly.
I'm keine Ahnung.
Yeah, I guess for now I'm turning the permaloader back on and the old mob switch. This is messed up.
I didn't bring anything, I don't even have repeaters now.
The messed up part is it doesn't unload in the end. Or in the overworld. And they're exactly the same. Copied them 100% correctly. I never noticed that, Nessie, but I also never spent considerable amounts of time with having an inventory opened while trying to repair stuff. Might be a thing.
Usually I don't use them often, so not much experience with it.
Okay, permaloader is unlocked again.
Okay, I have to rush back and get the repeaters.
Oof. What's wrong with the lag?
I went through a portal.
Oh, okay. Maybe we should tell XCOM to stop the dropping if you're close to the Shulkers now. But depending on how bad the TPS get.
Yeah.
Being close to them.
And going through a portal all the time is also probably not good.
Yeah. Not going through portals. Okay, let me reload the mob switch. And the two stupid chunks at the village loader are still loaded, so I don't know. What the crap. I'm actually mad.
Yeah, maybe XCOM can help at some point, I don't know. Yeah, I checked the top part today. So that's still good. But you can double check. So let's check the rails. Yeah, the next shulker would go in here. And it's fine, there's nothing in there. And next to it we already have one. Okay, so I just need to send them up now. We're making a Shulker separator. Shulkers in minecarts basically. Here we have stacks of 35 and we want to split them up to get them sorted out again. And then put them into the new mob switch that only has a single Shulker in there for every cell. Reason is the anti-cramming rule is currently set to 100. So this is fine at the moment, but if you want to set it to the default value of 24, then we would kill those Shulkers. So this is something, I don't know, we needed to do since, I don't know, months, but we always have procrastinating it, but now it's finally time. How many shulkers do we need? We still want to get 700 in total, and we have about 500 at the moment. But I just remember that we actually have 140 shulkers in the Nether. Maybe we should get those before they also get killed. Yeah, I know. It's been a while. This is not the most fun thing to do. That's why we kind of didn't do it. Especially if we lose a ton of shulkers today, that would not be funny at all. And it should be good. Oh, we actually need to do something to short pulse this. I think I'm just gonna surreptitiously by placing a button. There we go. That's actually interesting. The Shulker doesn't count towards that entity cramming rule. So currently we have the rule set to 100, and we actually have 70 Shulkers and 70 minecarts in one spot, but they don't get killed. Only the minecarts kind of add to that mob cramming rule. Yeah, so technically, if you get it to work, you can have thousands of Shulkers in a single spot, but I don't know how to do that even. Out minecarts. Yeah. Well, that's bad
how
for
to add
anyway.
Shulkers? Hmm? How to add 1,000 shulkers into one spot? Or what?
Yeah, can you do that somehow without minecarts?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, push them anyway, with pistons?
Push them. I always thought two shulkers can occupy the same spot. So they will teleport away if you try to do that.
Well, if they don't have a
if you prevent
valid
that,
location to teleport to, then that definitely works. Hmm. You have to make everything teleport proof though, and then you also get into lag issues because a shulker that sits in a location it should not be sitting in tries 10 times per second to teleport. So I think if you did this 1,000 times, it's not gonna be beneficial.
Okay, I guess we can get the first bunch of shulkers now. I really hope we don't lose some today. It would be really expensive.
Maybe make a region file backup?
I made a full backup yesterday.
Okay, it's at least something. So, worst to worst, XCOM loses 15 hours bedrock breaking. Screw him!
So we might be able to just replace the glass block here with a full block and then drive them out this way. But I probably should better take off my armor now. Yeah, dealing with shulkers is a pain. Now with the villager loader, it will kinda be better even to just also do the same op switch we have in the end dimension and nether dimension, just with a spawner somewhere in the overworld, to be honest.
Yeah, I said it's a kinda pointless to put more shulkers in. If we ever get to the point that we need to exceed it, we still have the zombie switch and we could just add a village loader there and Yeah, no, use it in case we are more than 10 people, which actually never happens.
Yeah, but we really need to get those Shulkers out now, because I don't want to lose them.
No.
Who knows? Maybe they might be used for something else. Alright. Wondering if we should maybe encase it somehow so they can't just drive off. Oh, they would actually drive off, right? And this looks kind of dangerous. might be not a bad idea to put some blocks around it. Just to be a bit safe. Can't be a bad idea. How can I get the rail then? We should leave one side open in case something goes wrong, they just fall down or something like that. So if something goes wrong, build a little holding cell. So the car only can go to one side here. Oh, water destroyed the rail, yeah. Okay, so let's just try this, and I think this shouldn't drive off now. Let's go.
Maybe you should build a rail on the bottom of the holding cell so you can handle the Shulkers easy if something
goes wrong. Oh yeah, good idea. Just put one here. Okay, good that I brought an extra minecart. That worked well. I'm not sure if they can drown. We'll see. What went even wrong there? Okay, so when they fell down, okay, we need definitely need a drop chute. I mean, they push each other all the time. Yeah. I need some more building blocks. Let's actually check if they're still alive. But if I leave this area now, then we have some issues. Let's check if we have something in the chest we can use. Yeah, let's just use the gold blocks as building blocks. Check the sharks real quick if they drown. Guess they don't. They shouldn't.
I think I found the issue.
They will
helps
drown.
To be, oh. Helps to be not stupid as hell.
They drowned.
Helps to have a village here too, and what the hell?
I don't know how many we lost. Depends how many we have still there. Probably a bunch. No, I really don't want to take backups, because some massive XCOM stuff. Let's see. Probably half them, 18 or so. No, 18 we lost.
You're in the overworld?
Yep.
You're also staying and not about to go in the nether?
Yep.
Alright, I fix it. Built the whole thingy, and then afterwards, when I implemented the whole locking grid, I've made one of the doors invalid by adding a stupid block. So I hope it works now. Let me kill Steven. Wait 2 minutes.
Should maybe keep an eye on the potion. Yeah, 4 minutes, that's good.
X comes straight up blamed Oreo.
No, it didn't work. Okay, we can resolve this by logging out, I guess. No. What? No, that is shooting. Come on. That works great. Works real great.
Hmm?
I already lost like 18 shulkers and not going too great as well now.
Yep.
Now they're stuck.
You know, I see this whole machinery from here. I'm just at spawn right now and I think I'm gonna stay here.
What the hell? Come on. Why? Let's try it with player unloading, I guess. Also, you shouldn't log out next to Shoy, because apparently the invisibility potion doesn't work like in the first ticker or something stupid.
Yeah, that would be OP. There's OP for map making, so. Can't have it. Hashtag invisibility 2 potions. When?
Shulk is in stacked minecarts, what a great combination. Yeah, I guess next time we have to use power railers in corners. We work on it already. What is the pyramid? It was the old Netherwood farm. Furnace minecart could be an idea, yeah. Can I go to the Nether methods?
You should be. Let me go into the Nether, then it messes up now, then it's my fault and not yours. Okay, I'm in, you can come.
Okay.
I just can blame myself if it messed up now. Okay, it's still there. I'm gonna go and turn off the permaloader and hope that it works now. This is all just because I had the thingy built and then afterwards added the locking system. I should have all done it in one go.
Yeah, 18 shulkers is quite a loss, but it's not the end of the world, I guess. If that's all in the end. Okay, furnace?
I think there's more than 18 shulkers in the end. Sorry.
Yeah, we can get them again, yeah. So it's like we lost all 210 shulkers. I mean, then definitely think about loading the backup.
Could still make that region fire backup.
I mean, I took a complete backup yesterday. It includes the region fire methods.
Yeah, but it also doesn't not include the progress XCOM made.
Yeah, I can just take those region files.
True. That would also. Okay, let's turn off the stupid old mob switch. Jesus Christ.
I was underestimating the. I'm not sure what to call it. So, if you have stacked minecarts and they fall down, they self propel themselves to the side.
The infinite momentum glitch.
Kind of forgot about that, and we need to make a drop chute.
Yeah, definitely.
Stupid mistake. Yeah.
This is also, I think, caused by the shulkers being bigger than the minecart.
No, it's only the minecarts would have already caused this.
But usually if you let stacked minecarts just fall down, they stay in the one by one. And then they start infinitely moving.
Put the potions there. Oh, come on. Yeah, nice.
Okay, we have the blazes are loaded, the withers did unload. And we're down to 150 chunks, few more minutes.
Wait,
and
there's some here.
And the perma loader should be fully gone. Yeah, yeah, it works now.
Oh! Okay, unloading worked this time. Are they in? Can hear them. Okay. I just need to get the rail out. I'm a bit scared. Okay, it worked. We kind of can get the raid load now, I guess. Okay, the other one. Okay. Better close. Oh, we can't close. Then we try to close it. Oh, let's just keep it. Should be good. I mean, it's encased. What's gonna happen? Okay. Now let's see. We need to probably get rid of some blocks again in order to make this work. I hope this works now. Let's try. There goes the first one. Yep. Okay. There goes a minecart. No, can we stop it? Of the empty minecarts got in the mix. Are they going? Brilliant. I already messed it up here, so the shulker went I don't know where, probably to unloaded chunks. Didn't check that rail line. Yeah, this is always the same if you work with Shulkers. Everything goes wrong, I mean... Every time, right?
It's the most painful mob to do anything with, more or less.
Always the same. There he comes. And there's the empty card in front. Ah, oh, I didn't see that. Can I? Oh!
Unload permaloader, man! Holy crap. Chunk loading is the second favorite thing after moving Shulkers, man. This is like actually getting more. Why? You're not in the Nether, right?
No.
Okay. You can, but I just need to make sure they know. Yeah, but the mob switch works now. Okay, it was just a door I made invalid.
Too late. Guess we have to get it out there manually again. Which one was it? That one? Yep. We need to move the Shulkers in order to prevent them from being killed from entity cramming. So we built that mob switch in 1.9 quite a while ago before they added the entity cramming rule. In order to not lose all the Shulkers, because we have stacks of 35 in there, we changed the entity cramming rule to 100. And now we want to change the entity cramming rule to the default value, and now it's, yeah, would be nice if you can get the Shulkers out before they get killed by entity cramming. Okay, let's actually fix this here. I'm getting one of those immediately now. I think we have two that teleported away here. Yeah. Let's try to get those.
Okay, these are the 25 permaloader chunks. What is all of this? So I locked 80 chunks of the permaloader and the rest still stays loaded. What is this? I guess I'm locking it fully now. Holy crap.
Did I only bring a stack of powered rails? Was could never be enough. Ah, oh, but I got more here. Yeah, and by the way, we already lost 18 Shulkers today. Not going too great. Okay, at least that works. The minecarts were self-propelling and the shark is drowned. They drove off in the ocean. I'm not even sure where the minecarts
are. They drown, right?
They're gone.
You just disappeared or what?
It's weird. Are those all the minecarts?
I mean, they don't take drowning damage, right?
They do, apparently.
But they don't take lava damage.
Yeah, that's the empty minecarts here. They all drowned in here.
The crap.
So that's how many shulkers we lost in minecarts. Damn. Oh, there's another one.
Still on. Okay.
You might notice if you have stacked minecarts and they fall down, they self-propel them. So they get infinite momentum if they are stacked. So basically you drop them down, instead of falling straight down, they swerve to the side and so on. Yeah, I forgot about the behavior. It was definitely my fault. Should have known. Okay. Oh yeah, actually wanted to get up. Oh, let's remove that redstone block manually again, then count how many we can send afterwards. Before we need to rebuild this thingy, or for the next layer. They don't get infinite momentum. I'm not sure what to call it, I mean.
They do get infinite momentum.
So there's three left. One, two, three. Yeah, looks like it.
Don't think Newton's law actually applies in Minecraft, so I'm going with the infinite momentum. Yeah, Germans, man, you can't make funny jokes here. Would jokes make our gameplay more efficient? The only thing that will change for us is some of our farms will actually get faster where we use entity cramming. And all the other effects, that's what we're working on fixing right now. I think it actually is infinite momentum because the minecarts push each other all the time. So if the world was infinite, they would actually go an infinite distance.
Maybe it means infinitely fast, whatever. Obviously not. It's capped at, I don't know, movement speed, like 8 blocks per second. They're not moving at the light of speed, yeah, probably means that. Yeah. But as Mephits already said, it's not real life physics.
Minecraft would be so bad if we had real life physics, man. It'd be so boring.
Yeah, I mean, look at the player. I mean, this is, oh, can't even look at the player. Invisibility. We'll probably weigh 500 kilograms, those fat Minecraft characters. They couldn't move at all.
And you know I'm gonna stay with infinite momentum now just to trigger the people, man.
Alright, we need to send two more of those guys. Then, wait a little bit. Can build the next layer. And my inventory, I don't know, just playing 5 minutes is already filled with stuff again. This...
You took 5 minutes to achieve that? This takes me literally a log in and my inventory is still messed up from the last time.
Hey, so. Oh, yeah, potion would be good again. We have that. What is it even? Terracotta? Blue terracotta here. Of course not. Or wasn't there some at the top?
Let's do a quick spawn mob caps. Oh, what? It's off! You gotta be kidding me! Why?
Oh, we need such a bot for the invisibility potions.
But actually crying. It unloaded. How?
Get in.
Okay, I'm gonna finish locking this and then I'll check
it. Didn't we have Schalke boxes at some point here? No, doesn't seem like it. Alright, then we have to go back. Go back, get blue terracotta. I have a suspicion we don't have any. It's just a slight suspicion.
Just update to 114 and don't have to worry about the chunk loading anymore. How long is this permalocker? The crap.
Go to 114, we have to put bots everywhere to win. And it doesn't even help. I mean, if you have to load those bots with those blazes with an extra bot, we're still gonna lag the game completely. So we effectively can't make a mob switch 1.14 without lagging the game.
And you can see in a second when I go to the mob switch again to figure out why it doesn't work, or the TPS go from 20 to 10. And then you know, this is not quite an option. Even inside of Vines, and if you pull all the tricks, it's like 100 times
slower. 3 stacks is actually quite a lot, it should be enough for a while. Should put some in the ender chest. Wasn't it renamed clay? The other way around, it was called hardened clay and now it's terracotta.
Isn't it still called hardened clay in command language until 1.13?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Methods is working the nether mob switcher. It's apparently also having fun.
Extreme fun.
Oh, my slime looks pretty nice.
Just really hope that I have another mess up with a door somewhere, but I highly doubt it. And then we're in the trouble zone now. How long is this permaloader though? The crap.
So I'm just putting in a new floor for new layer. Then we can send the next 14. We're moving Shulkers today from the old mob switch to the new one in order to be able to enable the entity cramming default rule of... what is it, 24?
24.
Kinda need it for the new Pikmin farm. We want to kill some.
Need to abuse it.
Some zombie pigmen with entity cramming it.
Funny thing, anyway.
Yeah, entity cramming is one of the fastest methods to kill mobs. I mean, I think only fall damage is really fast, or I don't know, it's something exotic like TNT damage or whatever. It's really good for that.
A typical Mojang feature. Technical community comes up with some uses after years and then intended behavior doesn't work at all. Good job. Fine code.
Alright, probably lost some glass.
If you're in a single player world, or you have like 2-3 people online, then it's fine to just get some mobs and put a bot there, but we need mob switches for 10 people plus, and standing next to 700 mobs, it's not like, oh yeah, let's not care about the lag. You're literally running at 10 TPS at that point. Also, an Enderman farm only blocks the mob cap in the end, not anywhere else. Hello.
Hey, one Maxi.
Okay, the whole permaloader has been locked. This time the village fully unloaded. Okay. Weird. I should probably mention this again, by the way, if anyone like sees the stuff I'm doing here or sees us talking about village chunk loading, do not do this in above 1.12. Just a fair warning, you don't want to wreck your hardware.
Yep, the rails are reset. Does that automatically. Now I lost track. We probably don't have 14 anyway left. Do we?
Yeah, it was out danger in 1.12, but in 1.13 they messed up some stuff and this actually... What does it do? It wrecks your hard drive?
Yep.
Yep, so it's SSD actually gonna kill your SSD. This is fixed again in 1.14 by force unloading literally everything. But in 1.13, wouldn't recommend that. Yeah, nether portals is still a problem. It's not only mobs, everyone that goes through a nether portal.
Looks like three mobs. Unless it's cached. Don't have to go up. Nice.
Okay, player spawn.
Streamed for an hour, but it feels like 3 hours already. Oh, we're exhausted. Oh, there's an empty card again. Yep, got it. Another one, okay. So many empty cards, what's going on? And that's it apparently. First batch. Feels like we lost even more somehow. Bullet hits, ah yeah, true. We lost probably even 20 or so. 21. Oh. Alright, don't just
what,
do
let
this
me actually just move this
five more times
door. Oh yeah, Mango, maybe you wanna hit tap real quick and show the people what happens if you don't have your mob switch in a lazy chunk.
Hmm? Oh, the MSBT?
10 TPS.
Yeah, yeah. All the Schalkers. Pretty bad.
No, it's also the 700 blazes.
Also
unloading
the blazes,
right now.
Yeah, okay.
So yeah. I'm trying to fix the mob switch, so that's yeah. Why you effectively can't make a mob switch anymore. Of course, if you're in single player or something like that, or you have two people on the server and you only need 140, this is a different story, but.
Okay, if you yeah. mine if we mine now and let them drop down and we have the same issue, it would spray everywhere, so we definitely need to make some kind of a shoot. Probably easier than. Yeah, let's do that. The new tunnel boss schematic. I'm not sure. I can.
You're in,
ask me in Discord maybe afterwards and can give you one.
Are you in the overworld?
Yep.
Are you gonna stay as well?
Yep.
Alright. 2 minutes. Resetting the mob switch.
Let me actually do it in order. So let's rebuild the other drop chute again so we can get the Schalkers in. Such a chaos, by the way.
Kill Steven.
Nowhere to go.
I've now added another hopper into the chunk loading grid.
Some slaps would be
XCOM
nice.
XCOM is slightly tripping.
What's going on?
Overworld mob switch is the most critical emo. All the bots in witch huts cause issues if someone turns the mob switch on. By the time we have 10 double huts, we would need over 10 mob switches. You kinda don't want a mob switch while running a witch hut.
Okay, so let's go for it. I really hope they don't go into the ocean again. Let's see what happens. That look good. It looked really good.
Okay. 731 mobs, so why unload?
Yeah, I got 3 minutes left, but I better drink one. We have enough.
And it's gone. And 2 chunks of the 25 stay loaded. Let me write them down so I can show it to XCOM.
We need 2 more, right?
231.
Yep.
261. 231. 260.
Okay, let's go for it. No, I forgot something. The rails. Almost broke it again. I think it was Mephit's telephone. Yep. Got 1, 2. Okay, it's gonna take a while until they're up. Gonna take a break for a minute or two. Alright, I'm back. Yeah, we're moving the Schalkers over. Bye, keine Ahnung. I think by now it should be enjoyable because we figured it out, I guess. No, it's just going through the motions, hopefully. Hope we don't lose anymore. Uh, It's like the real exciting or real annoying thing would be moving the shulkers from the Nether over. Oh boy, don't look forward to that. Because we have to first fly them over, then set up some kind of a portal system to get them back to the overworld. That's gonna be such a pain.
Yeah, I really can't tell anymore why it unloads now.
Well, we had 140 shulkers in the Nether at some point. Idea was also to have some kind of a movable mob switch for the Nether dimension. I mean, by now this is obviously not really that good, but yeah.
Well, this was pre-perma-loading,
yeah,
so...
Yeah, this was used in 1.9, or 1.10 or so, years ago. And that's why we did that.
We used them at the first Nether Quarry.
Yep.
360 by 360.
It would be a shame to just lose those 140 shulkers. So I'll try to get them back to the overworld in here. On rail. We certainly won't update to the current state of Minecraft 1.14. I mean, I can't play without a mob switch anymore. Just to think about it, getting harassed by gas all the time again, or your creepers
this
in the
This is not the worst part about it. The worst part is about it, zero chunk loading.
That as well, yeah.
Can adapt to mobs again.
No.
And most of the time we are not 10 people and you could still mob switch it. I mean, you did it before any chunk loading with having bots standing there.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah.
So this is not even the biggest issue at all, mob switch. Besides the fact that it still works, I mean, we have a non-chunk loaded mob switch right now. You're working on it.
The problem isn't that the survival game would be hard. The problem is that you can't use something like a tunnel bore anymore. Because it's just gonna blow up all the time. Because there's a creeper, whatever. You just can't use certain machines anymore. Unless you do something ridiculous, like add it. Oh, we could actually use the tunnel bore still. If you add light sources now all around the machine. But then it can still walk in from the side. Yeah.
Also from front.
Yeah.
It's not like you have 10 blocks of space in front of the tunnel bore, even more, which you cannot light. Because there's explosions going on.
XCOM is removing Bedrock.
Yeah, I guess I'm flicking the permaloader back on. What the hell?
Okay, got the next layer, I guess. It's in the next 14. Just waiting until I take off my Elytra and jump down. Didn't even die yet on stream today.
I have one more idea, maybe it's related to the way I leave the area. Maybe killing yourself is not the best way of doing this.
Overworld.
And I cannot test it since I cannot trigger the wire. Are you in the overworld?
Anuna says he never had problems with the talent pool and survival without a mob switch. Really? Just can't imagine it at all.
I guess if you have a 10 wide tunnel board and it's not that big of a deal because mobs don't spawn within 24 blocks of you.
So it didn't hit any caves? Then we weren't using it much.
Yeah. Also, if you have a small tunnel board, it's no issue at all. If you make that thingy 500 blocks wide, then I give you like 2 minutes before it's blown up.
To a quite certain extent, exactly 14. Should I actually maybe add a dropper counter? It would be nice. Keep track. But I don't have a dropper. Yeah, I'm quite sure it was 14. Why 220?
Okay, kill Steven. Oh, don't go in the nether.
Okay. Maybe we can actually craft a dropper, but I don't think we have cobble here.
Can give you one.
That would be nice.
But you have to come to the portal, I'm not invisible.
Thanks. Alright, build the next layer. Oh, okay. I think we got a routine by now. Hi, Savage Anna. I'm good at redstone, but I'm terrible at bringing materials.
No, they're still loaded. This is weird. Yeah, because the permaloader is back on. Yeah.
Yeah, but shouldn't the village keep it keep itself loaded? I mean, it just kind of works for the iron farm. It works for the other mob switch.
It just doesn't.
What are you doing? I'm bringing Shulkers over to the new mob switch from the old one. So we built a minecart unsorter or unstacker here at the bottom. Currently we have the shulkers in packs of 35. So we bring them to the minecart unstacker and then we separate them and send them up one by one where they put into holding cells. Well, Spike, you're the best around, really. Thanks for the $100. And also, Merry Christmas to you.
The music is moving.
I was checking how good we have the dropper counter now. I don't think there was an empty minecart this time. And the last one.
Again.
I wouldn't say we abuse them. We use them for mob switch. We rescued them from the cold end and bring them home to their new home here at spawn of cozy cells. So yeah, a lot nicer here.
Hey ho.
Yeah, but abusing in sandbox game, it doesn't work. Some have to use it. It's definitely a lot better than just killing them to get the shells.
That's abusing to get the shells or what?
Yeah. Those friendly shulkers there. Yeah.
I mean, it's intended behavior what we're doing here.
Don't you see we're giving them a second shell? You know, they like their protection, being in a nice cozy space. We're giving them an extra layer.
Well, for now I'm leaving the wither switch off and just leave the place switch on with the permaloader together. So
okay.
We have the 10 mob caps. We have to figure out what's going wrong here.
Yep, maybe XCOM just needs to take a look at some point.
Yeah, there's not much he can look at. I mean, it can't be... So I fixed the one door that was broken. There was obviously a flaw. Now the permaloader is on and I see the 25 chunks, so it cannot be a missing hopper or a missing item. I've showed him the screenshots. You can see the 8 doors going into the 8 chunks that are around the center chunk. It's gotta be the villager stopping to be ticked or something. So I really don't know.
Hey Kovado. Can shulkers move minecarts?
No, they can't.
No, they can't.
They don't pathfind like other mobs.
Yep.
They just TP to places. It would be insane if they just teleported with the cart.
That would be bad. I think some people are suggesting to not put them into carts, just push them over with pistons, but I don't trust it.
It works, just a lot more work.
Okay, put another layer.
And every time you push one of them or do something like that, you have to teleport proof everything, because they will try to teleport, and then you only can have this one spot where he can't AP to. And then every next shulker you need another spot to TP to. This would be horrible.
Oops. Yeah, I think I need to put one rail back. That's just 5. Alright, I'll try to get some blocks so we can get the next batch. I'll take everything. Planks, iron blocks, everything works. Oh wait, not doing the right order again. First we need to prepare the other drop chute for the unstacker. Roughly what percentage of Schalkes are still homeless at this point? You mean what's planned for today? So we moved 70 Schalkes, lost about 20. We got 140 left. So like 33% is done, 67 needs to be done. And then we also still have some in the Nether. I talked about this earlier. We still need to move 140 Schalkes from the Nether back over to the overworld. Would be shame to lose them. And we can also get some from the Interdimension. I think we already put like 45 or so into minecarts. Can also get those over. In the end, it would be nice if you get 10 mob caps, so 700 Schalkes in total. Okay, we lost like 20. So if you bring those from the Nether over, we have 630, and we need to get 70 more from the end.
Potion is running out.
Oh, good. Thanks.
Wow, today's a lot of delay. Frostro, if you having a server where you kind of want to play technical and you're looking for people to join you, I think you can join the Psycraft Discord. If you don't like spam it 10,000 times a day, it's fine to advertise your small server.
Okay, next batch. Seems good.
Yeah, I'm not sure how it is with advertising on the TMC, so that's why I didn't mention that.
Okay. Yeah, it seems like we got a routine now. Hey, Fizz.
Is it Fizz guy or is it PHYZ guy? In my head, it's definitely PHYZ.
He's at a... I can say Fizz.
Okay.
I think in the beginning I tried with Fizz, but it... I'm not sure. What happened here? Okay. Okay. What? Did I forgot to place rails or what happened here? Why would he leave the minecart? The minecart is completely gone? What? What? No! Oh! It was a bug apparently. What? Okay. Sometimes this game is weird.
No, oh, I was muted. I think this might be the new carpet version, Mango.
Did Robert bans them?
No, that they like disappear and do stuff. I moved a villager earlier today, and multiple times he turned invisible in front of me.
Okay.
And I always had to relog to see him again and stuff is going on. And yesterday the stuff with the you turning invisible and me client-side picking up the items, which never happened before, so...
That's nice if we have our own bugs now.
Yeah. The nice part about it is they actually get fixed.
Yeah. But I definitely didn't turn anything else on. Or, I don't know, would something turn on by default? It's a bit weird. I predicted it. It was just a matter of time until it happens. Goodbye, 778 levels. Also have to take
at least you're not far away.
Letters
man.
Of shame.
Why don't you grab yeah. to your ender chest and just fly down again?
Yeah, my ender chest that I just lost.
I mean, you could use the one that's placed up there.
Oh, there was one? Okay.
Yeah. But I guess you deserve the letter of shame.
Yep.
You should add some signs on it in every layer, like, shame on you! There used to be a chest with enderpearls up there, but someone removed it to save on lag. Thank you.
Really?
Yeah.
Like that. you can't actually do much with 700 levels. That's the thing. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was just AFKing the other day, just testing out the new pigment form for, I think, 10 hours. It was pretty good. You got 700 levels.
This is the quickest way to divide your levels by factor 10, man. See? 7 left. It's factor 100, so.
Actually, I want to get something. Blocks. Oh, yeah, new potion. Good. Hey, let me watch you. Not really early. I think I've been streaming for 100 minutes. I wouldn't call this nothing. I'm moving Shulkers over from the old mob switch where they are stacked in packs of 35 to the new mob switch where they all get their own cell. Reason is we want to change the mob cramming rule. Currently it's 100 and we want to set it to the default value of 24. That's why we have to bring over the Shulkers, since they would get killed by the minecarts once we switch. Alright. Now the next 14. Anything we need to do still? No. Yeah, that's fine. The passive mob switch is enabled by default, yeah? That's hard to see that pig switch over there. Yeah, it's chunk board of the spawn chunks. So this is the pig mob switch. I just found out the other day the tamed wolves also count towards the passive mob cap. Did you know that back then, Methods? Methods? Might be gone.
Tamed wolves?
Yeah, they count towards the passive mob cap.
Good stuff.
Could have used those instead.
Don't know how this makes it easier though.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, you still have to breed them.
You realize that this chunk is loaded and that someone hits me, that there is an intended thingy in this game.
Sit down, right?
No, yes, if they sit down.
Really?
It's even intended that they have a chance, if they are in a loaded chunk and their owner gets damaged, they have a chance to teleport there, kill the guy that's hitting you, and then sit down again.
Okay.
Great feature, right there. This is exactly what you want if you sit your dog down. This is the reason you have to put them in minecarts wherever you use them. I had them at the start in the leaf farm, I didn't have him in the minecart, and he regularly teleported to me when someone loaded that area. So, and then I recently checked the Minecraft's wiki for wolves, and it's even in there as an intended behavior.
Yeah, I don't know anybody that regularly uses wolves for anything. I mean, just,
it's a pain.
Is anybody on a Hermitcraft server using the wolves except for, I don't know, having them?
The occasional skeleton farm, maybe. This is about all you can do with them.
This is not exactly intended. I'm not sure. I think the intended way would be to travel with your wolf or whatever, but yeah, this doesn't work at all.
Use them every 2 minutes. Even if they manage to not kill themselves by following you, they also do stuff like teleporting into non-solid blocks like hoppers. And then they sit there and it's like, great.
Cats are different. They definitely don't count towards the passive mob cap.
That's what I always... 140. The wolf needs to be the only mob that does that, because other tamed mobs do not count towards that.
Taming horses, because the ocelot is a hostile mob.
Yeah, but for example, taming horses, they do not count to the mob cap. Taming cats, they do not count to the mob cap. It's probably a bug even that they still do that. Definitely shouldn't.
Yeah, so they're mostly used as decoration, and for some farms, probably can also use them for, I don't know, rabbit farm, to kill the rabbits with wolves, maybe?
Scare them away.
Or scare them, yeah.
Don't think you get to... Oh, well, maybe you could use it, but the rabbit's foot drop chance without looting is so, so low. It's not really worth.
You mean you're... I'm quite sure your dogs won't attack the rabbits. Only the wild ones.
Oh, only the wild wolves? Yeah, okay, but the drop rates for the feed are so low that this is probably not worth it at all. Have to use looting for that. Back in the day, you could use them for wither skeleton farms, but they removed that as well. Which I always thought was a nice trade-off. You can take your good farm that really produces a lot with looting, and then you can just throw 10 wolves there, and you get at least a few skulls per hour. But then they removed it. No longer drop skulls. No, the only mob that used to drop
was
player
pet.
Stuff is pets.
I don't know if your pet Yama. No, it doesn't count. I suppose only wolves. No.
Can't have a pet Yama.
You can tame them.
It's not a pet.
Are you sure? I mean.
Yes. Does he follow you around? You tame him? No.
Okay.
The only pets that are is freaking wolves, cats, and is the... I'm not sure, is the parrot a pet?
What about the horse?
Doesn't follow you around either.
Okay.
It's not a pet, it's just a tame.
Yeah, we have an idea when the next... it's probably gonna be an 18-hour primitive livestream, hopefully, so... Definitely have more ambitious goals for the next one. It's gonna be December 29th, so the weekend after the next one. Oh, in 9 days. Parrot follows, yeah.
And the parrot is a real pet, too.
Still have to redesign some machines, so. Still don't know why the transship blew up, and we need to do something about the stone gen to make it faster.
Neil grew. Yeah, they used to drop heads, but they no longer do since 1.9, which is like by now 3 years ago.
Yeah, I made a bug of the week video at some point about
it. This is marked as a bug, but I'm 99% certain that they want it this way. I mean, this is literally a 30-second loot table change. Like, this wither skeleton skull doesn't accidentally disappear out of your loot table.
I'm not sure about the game that has changed. Now the technical players can't use it anymore. Great, right? So now they have so much more fun with the game. to make clicking bots. Alright, next layer.
Yeah, that's the thing I always disliked. So you had a chance to AFK over the Skelly Farm legit, and now what do all the people do? Yep, scripting.
Yep.
Replace that with scripting. Good stuff.
I mean, it even came at a price. I mean, you didn't get the looting on it.
It was super slow. Yeah. I mean, if you don't use looting, you think you get one skull per 100 skellies or something.
Every... No, it's not that bad anymore.
Okay, maybe it's every 70 or whatever.
Okay, should maybe drink a potion. No, it was 2.5% every 40 skeleton.
Okay.
And with the looting, it's like every 18 or so. Yeah.
I like the scripting better anyway.
Okay, going back. Thinking about getting some blocks.
It does not depend on how you place the TNT, it only depends on how you light the TNT. So if you flint and steal the TNT, then yes, it counts as player kill, but I think if you lever it, it doesn't? Maybe? Not quite sure.
What is it about? The TNT... Well, you kind of need to place it, but I play it. It's the only way to place it. You have to use a flint and steel. You have to use a flint and steel. Then yep. It's a player
so even
TNT.
If you put a... So even if you put a button on top of the TNT and trigger that button, it's
no,
not
how would it detect
loot.
That? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, fire arrow would work too.
Oh yeah, also not.
What happens if you light a netherrack next to a TNT and it spreads over and ignites it though? Probably also doesn't count as player kill. No, it only applies to the TNT that you have lit, personally.
Pikmin don't get angry from TNT. Yeah, it depends. I think if the player ignites it, then they do.
Yeah.
If you, I don't know, shoot a TNT into them, then not. It's one from a dispenser.
You have to ignite it with a flint and steel, not with a
dispenser.
Redstone. Huh. Yeah, or dispenser or something. So only through flint and steel they can track ownership.
Yeah, or fire arrow. What probably also works is deflecting a gas ball onto a TNT.
Could work, yeah.
Yep, because if a ghast shoots at you and you deflect that ghast ball and you hit a Pikmin, they definitely get mad at you. So I could imagine that this also works. So I think if you deflect a gas ball, it's pretty much your projectile.
Hey, monkey.
Not sure about igniting a creeper.
Hmm. Okay, that works. We don't do enchanting. We always buy books from the villagers and combine those with the anvil. So if you look at my statistics, items enchanted 0 in 0.96 years of playtime.
I love when content creators reach out and ask, what content should I be making to stay relevant to what Minecraft players are interested in? Proactive and smart content strategy.
Wait,
GG to those who have. And if you haven't, door is always open. No.
Okay. Reddit or what?
Aubrey Norris.
Okay. So what should this? Did you say is he? I like it when content creators reach out and ask whom what
content... He's offering help to content creators to tell them what content they should be making to stay relevant.
Okay.
AKA, I can already give you the answer, man. Play Skyblock and make clickbait titles like crazy, and then you just get paid by those abusive servers, and you really don't need to worry about the content you're actually creating because you're making the money from those servers anyway. There you go.
Imagine asking Mojang what content you should make. Shouldn't maybe do that.
Yeah, then I guess you don't want to stay relevant. I mean, we basically do RNG manipulation to get our enchants. We RNG breed villagers until we get the guy that has the perfect trade for us.
How is this manipulating? Who's still relying
not really.
On random
yeah. Yeah, but I mean, we sort of, you know, we manipulate it to the game so we get exactly the enchants we want. Just do it in a better way. How do you guys come up with all the things you build? Someone has some idea or needs some drop or some block or some other thing and then just do it. It's no specific way to come up with ideas. Just have the goal to automate everything that's possible and get at least a double chest of every item and from there, you can take all the ideas. I don't think you can RNG the traits of villagers.
Oh, my Twitch integration probably broke. Sorry. No, yeah, don't think that works. We would have heard by now if it works. I mean, they went through pretty much everything already. It's, yeah, checked where it's useful.
And apparently there's a firework rocket RNG.
And?
Yeah, nothing. No, you cannot manipulate the traits.
How much iron have you mined before first iron form? I wasn't on the server in the early days. Rego probably knows.
Sorry?
Do we know how much iron you have mined before you built the first
exact
iron
numbers,
farm?
Please.
Yeah.
Okay. No.
Doesn't even know how much iron he mined.
So is this something again with the desync or whatever? Did I make a mistake somewhere? Did I send them too quick? Let's log out.
Just relog. Oh, unloaded. Just fly away.
Might have made a mistake. Are there two in there? That's the question. It's the only thing I could imagine that happened.
Hit F3B.
Oh, yeah. Can you see that?
Maybe.
No. Guess we can try. Let's see.
Turn it on and off, right? That should split them.
Ah, that's a good one, huh? Yeah. Let's do that. Almost jumped again, by the way. Last second room, remembered.
Also, we really don't need to RNG villagers, even if it would be possible, because we have a set of perfect ones. Can't get better. Hey, you can RNG the lightning, so we're definitely gonna have a double chest of all mob pets.
That's interesting. Okay.
I don't think you... Maybe you can do RNG in 1-8, but not the way you do it past 1-8.
Yeah, because
it definitely
the
has to do with dimensions.
Wasn't it always the last structure that
yeah,
was
exactly.
added? So wouldn't it be then the Guardian Temple? I don't know.
Yeah, but
maybe.
I think that doesn't work because the area isn't big enough or some tricky stuff.
Yeah, you need to ask the code diggers.
Earth Computer or XCOM or to know some of the people that actually have a clue what they're talking about in regards to RNG.
So, how are we gonna do this?
Yeah, take off your light.
Alright then. Extra mic up, maybe just split them.
It should work to just hit the button again. Or that. There he is, how to summon the XCOM.
That went surprisingly well. Okay.
How much more do you have to go? Still
a lot.
No, I mean in the tower.
Oh, a few layers, six, seven or so.
Was 6-7 layers. Oh, we have normal rails in that chamber. You just closed. Thanks.
I should wait a bit more now between pushing the button again.
Non-fully automatic Schalke Anstecker. Casuals. It's already fixed.
Is it worth attaching a timer? Maybe.
Well, we had like a fully automatic system. We even tried everything and tested it all, and apparently we lost the world and no one knows where it is. So we had to redesign a quick one. We had a fully automatic setup for sure.
Oh, they're all not over there. That's not that good. Might see me. Send them over.
Who's talking about RNG?
Someone asked if you can RNG villager traits.
Stop cheating.
But yeah, you can't. So.
How dare you cheat?
Can you RNG the Nidwit crafters?
Probably not.
No, you can't.
No.
It's entity RNG. You can, however, get RNG to make Nidwits only.
Really?
Yeah. Okay. So you could do RNG to only get librarians or what?
That's cool.
I would be up for that.
I want that.
On the other hand, you could ask.
Since you asked, who asked about RNG stuff? Probably just some random guy in chat.
Well, that guy is chilly.
On the other hand, you can also just reconvert the librarian over and over.
Do Nidwits cause less lag?
No.
Wouldn't be surprised. Cause more lag for some reason. It's more jank.
No. If they actually do all the other stuff and then they have like something in there that cancels it on every day. Get opposite. That's the funniest end.
I've seen it a few times by now that they made if statements or whatever that it's just, I don't know, are completely useless. So, a few of those mistakes in there.
If fence gate.
No, I meant more redundant.
The best piece of redundant code we've seen recently is definitely the observer placement. Get opposite. It's definitely a slight derp. Yeah, someone in Mojang added to the game that you can put fence gates on top of farmland without turning the farmland into dirt via if statement. But he forgot about all the other blocks, like slabs and trapdoors, all kinds of other stuff. Kinda sad.
Depending on the spawn point, the spawn chunks are 16 by 16 to 17 by 17 chunks.
Unless you're playing 114.
And the lazy chunks are basically a boundary of two chunks all around it. Why do I have a dropper and rails in it? Just to have a counter.
Counter.
It's kinda hard to keep track sometimes.
Unless you're playing 114, as we recently saw, the spawn chunks are bigger there. Up to 23 by 23.
Oh, got the potion.
Mattis, were you having issues with the thingy again?
Yeah. It unloads unless I turn on the permaloader.
Can we go there?
If you want. I can summon in a bot though, so you don't despawn the blazes. One sec.
Same spot again. Something wrong, maybe? The top?
Seems like it. Send him too fast.
Something needs to be wrong. Okay, I think I fixed it manually. We'll probably have the same issues again like last time. Probably two in the first cell.
You ready, XCOM?
What did it fix? It fixed itself? What? No, we had a desync again. Oh, come on, what's going on?
Should I set you to game mode 3 and you take a look at it? XCOM?
Can't you hear me?
Yet, now I can. Hello, hello?
Yeah, I'm carefully logging in because I'm inside of the perimeter.
Okay.
The now command doesn't get updated anymore. Now I'm just preparing cells for the shulkers. So put it on a new floor so we can drop new ones from the top.
quite like it, the server.
I'm at spawn. There's so many shulkers.
I'm loading 700 places as well.
So we have 1200 entities loaded.
Mm-hmm.
Bad.
My Exxon wants to take a look at the play switch, so...
Okay.
I'm coming over.
I can also set you to game mode 3 and get you here.
No! I'll get there the conventional way. So how do you get there?
$3,700, $4,200, top of the nether. See you in 10 minutes.
Did you bring a pick over? The carrot on a stick. Fastest AFK trouble.
I'm still waiting for that feature, by the way. Maybe XCOM can do it. XCOM. I want to pick that I name the mango to go twice as fast. As an Easter egg.
That would be actually fun. You have racing pigs. They're a bit faster.
If there
Why
was...
do you guys want to have pigs? That's slavery. Poor pigs. You're either...
Another good one would actually be Yama racing, because you can't control them at all. It would be so dumb. Quarter mile Yama racing.
There is no direct line, right? You have to just... go on top of the nether roof and then just try.
Yep. He actually teleports Steven a little bit closer to the blazes, so we don't have any despawns.
Yeah, breeding for the fastest pick. Oh, that would be nice.
Yeah, it would actually be funny if you could have a pick that goes like 3.21 blocks per second.
Yeah.
You have to breed like 100,000 pigs to get a fast one.
Definitely try to get a fast pig. So I'm just gonna send a single one because I still don't trust the system right now. Yeah, seems fine.
Maybe it just went too fast again.
No. They have the extra leg, probably. No. Is that the last one? Yep.
It's kind of nice when the server is lagging, your rockets are kind of doubled. It's like twice as long rockets.
God, do we reach now 50% or what? One... Wait, I can't see. Yeah. The first batch, second batch, fourth batch. Okay. Two more batches left. I'd have to admit this is quite cumbersome. I'm getting a bit tired. Oh, first system needs to be
probably
repaired.
Maybe stop it then before you mess it up.
Yeah, there's always another day. Also think I need to eat something soon, yeah.
Eating's for the week. Oh, there is the XCOM.
Just arrived.
Okay. Also, I'm gonna check out real quick what Method's gonna do to end the stream.
So, should I set you to game mode 3 now so you can take a look from on top, XCOM?
No, no, it's, yeah, I think these hop. I'm just gonna look at the hoppers and the doors.
So they all have items in them, I just tripled check them for the fourth time.
So that's the blaze switch here.
I don't understand.
Ah, oh, too many blaze. Reload them. That's why the server's struggling a little bit. And for some reason we're having problems to keep this loaded. No, normally the village mechanic should do it.
And I've even added a second hopper now, XCOM, here, from the center chunk outwards, like you suggested. Didn't do anything.
The center
chunk. The items in all the hoppers.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, this one. No, you don't need this one.
Yeah, I've added it just for safety reasons. It makes no difference. Still unloads.
Server specs, i7-4790K and 32GB of RAM.
Oh, but this instance runs on like 6 or something, right? So yeah, kind of stuck here. As you can tell, these doors are all in the correct locations now. They're all registered as door as well. I really don't know.
Wait, don't you need a... No, okay, those are also village doors, huh?
They're all valid.
Mm.
Hit F7.
Mm-hmm.
Is the center one also? Because it's like, you can barely see there is two different lines definitely. Coming out.
It is valid. I can move it if you want.
Yeah, give it a try.
Yeah, but it's just because they're on the same axis, so this line is like hard to tell, but it is a valid village door. Move the leg. Let's put that sucker here.
Yeah, you can see the line now.
There it is.
And it's just in a way. Yeah, but you can easily see it now.
Yeah, but I mean, I've started from the center here and just registered as a door, and then I started doing the outside, so... I know how village mechanics work. I'm actually the guy who fixed your overworld thingy. So...
What the fuck is going on with this door? Why is it going from the middle of the line? What the fuck? How did you manage to get one of those top doors?
I don't know, I just registered the top half of the door as valid.
That's odd, yeah.
That's not supposed to happen.
Does make no difference. Probably block the top here and remove this one, and now it should actually move down. No, it doesn't want to, whatever. But yeah, I'm out of solutions here.
Yeah, I'm gonna look
definitely at... work.
How do you see the village bounding box that's part F7. Of the public client?
Oh,
the village is gone.
No, sometimes the client is a bit buggy and it disappears.
Oh, it disappears for me too at the same time.
Why is the carpet mod called carpet mod? The first features that Gnambun added were involving placing a carpet. check for mob spawning conditions and so on. Was using carpets for that. Anyway, let's say end the stream here. Probably gonna continue tomorrow with the Shulkers, get the rest over, and also bring those from the Nether over. Yeah, thanks a lot for watching. Let's check if somebody we could raid.
Let's check.
Suzuma! Yep, let's raid Suzuma. Okay guys, gonna send you over to Suzuma from the Hermitcraft server. I'm gonna stream tomorrow again, probably also start like today in the afternoon German time. Bye guys!
Bye.
Bye.